Okay, so you filed your application, you have your filing receipt, and now we're going to talk about post-filing consideration. So, first of all, if you filed a provisional, it will expire in 1 year, so you need to file a non-provisional to continue the protection. So docket the date in your calendar for 1 year or a little bit before, because you could add additional material to that non-provisional when you file it. Secondly, if you filed the non-provisional, you can't add more material to that non-provisional. You'd have to file a new application, but you have a 1 year period to file in other countries based on that non-provisional. So docket that date, and if you get some traction for your invention, you can think about international filing. So those are the first dates that you should be putting down. Secondly, once the application issues, there's maintenance fees that need to be paid at the 3.5 year mark, the 7.5 year mark, and the 11.5 year mark in the US. In other countries, maintenance fees or annuities need to be paid practically every year. So in Canada, they start after the second year. In Europe, I think it's a similar thing, but it's every year that these annuities need to be paid. So while you have a patent pending, whether or not it's been issued, you need to pay these annuities to keep the patents valid. So whatever application you filed, that's gonna start your time ticking. So you have a 1 year period to file internationally. Now at the 1 year mark, you can file the PCT application. So PCT is Patent Cooperation Treaty. It is basically a process that facilitates the filing into foreign countries, but also gives you a further delay before you have to do that. So if you file a normal application, like a provisional or non-provisional, you have a 1 year period. If you file a PCT application, you have 30 months from the earliest priority date. So if you filed a PCT application as your first application, which you can do, you have 30 months of validity before you have to choose countries to file in. Now, if you filed a PCT as the first application, at the 30 month, if you wanted protection in the US, you would have to file a US non-provisional application at that time. Now, the PCT, if you file a provisional and then you file a PCT at the 1 year mark, then it'll give you a further 18 months. So it gives you a total amount of time to the earliest filing date of 30 months. So if you file at the 1 year mark for the PCT, in 18 months, you'll have to file nationally. So for the national filings, I'll give you some strategy pointers and basic general costs for the filing so you know what to expect. So if they're in a foreign language, you need to file a translation of your application. Now, there are a few exceptions. Europe, even though a lot of foreign languages are used there, the application can be filed in English under the EPO regional filing program. So just Google EPO and to have a look at that. That covers, I think, about 32 countries in Europe. And it's an expensive and time-consuming process, but you get a lot of coverage for the money. So for other countries that you can file in directly is Canada. You can file with English, with your English application. You can file in England, you can file South Africa, you can file Australia, and I think that's it for now. The rest would need translations then, and if you're looking at China or other countries, then you can usually find an associate online who can help you with that. But be careful, there's a lot of scam artists out there and they may just take your money and not file that application. So buyer beware with foreign filings. You may want to get a patent attorney to help you organize the foreign filings and collaborate with foreign attorneys in order to kind of guarantee and streamline the process. However, you'll pay something for the oversight of that attorney. So that is it for foreign filings. Just keep in mind that if you miss those dates, then you can't file in those countries anymore, and basically your invention is then public domain. So if you want to maintain protection for the inventions, think about the markets where you'll be selling your product and cover those first. Some of the countries where you'd manufacture don't have the same rigid patent respect and protection that you get in sort of Western countries, so it may not be worthwhile filing there. But that having been said, China and Hong Kong and some other jurisdictions are increasing their protection on patents so that, you know, their patents are also respected in other countries. So it's an ongoing process. But at this time, I'd recommend filing in the markets you plan to sell the product in. So, you know, generally Europe and US and maybe Canada and Australia in the mix. That's up to you, but I wish you the very best of luck on your journey as an inventor.